And here we go. The Lansdale car is headed and caught out in the slick condition.
Yes, coming out of tyre power. A turn at Forest Elbow has caught the edge of the track, the slippery conditions, and has hit the wall by the look of it, and is now really caught in the sludge there off the side of the track. Now reversing out into very dangerous territory.
Well, I can say that's goodbye engine there. And now how does Peter McLeod get by? He's got to weave through. He knows he's got faster cars. Okay, Lansdale getting out of the way. That's a decent maneuver on his part. I'd say that engine is cooking. If he hit the he can forget it. He can't get that back. Well, he can get it back, but it won't be anything drivable when he tries to restart it.
Well, again, he's now going to have to try and struggle all the way down Conrod Strait.
There's the water pouring out of the radiator. He'll be very lucky to get down to Castro Chase. Caltase Chase.
To break
that bumper bar, that'll be havoc for any car to hit that front spoiler that's been parked there by the Lansdale boys.
And there's no Marshall game to duck out to retrieve that because they're coming out of tyre power turn there, lickety split. And
the McLeod family will be replaying this for some years to come, and I know NZ happily supporting their cause for a number of years. Certainly no fitting's gone wrong on
right
it.
Back to the
I believe it's just broken. It's just broken the Watsley.
Well, there we are. It's made me eat my words. I said nobody be going to dart out and do that, and he's done it. Well done.
Our Australian marshals are famous around the world, Richard, for their bravery and for their intelligence, and I don't think we need to be too ashamed of that at all.
Tony Longhurst continues to lead this race, by the way, with from Greg Murphy after that serious scrap three or four laps back. He's now edges about to 8 seconds. Let's have a look at this as... Now what the hell happened there? He didn't hit anything. The back of the car just went away from him.
Could have been power oversteer, Gary. He hit the gas pedal a little.